Hello, everyone. I am Robert Martin, and once again, I would like to welcome you to a heart-pounding action of sports where champions are made and legends are born. Central Michigan won their homecoming game against the Akron Zips 17-10 to bring their overall record to 4-3. In those other three wins this year, the Chips put up 45, 34, and 26 points. So the right question to ask is exactly, how did they come out on top? What stood out? The only answer to that question is one that does not get talked about enough, and that is the offensive line. They dominated the entire game in the run and pass game with allowing only two sacks and destroying the time of possession statistically, having the ball 37 minutes compared to Akron's 22. I do not see their success in the trenches decreasing anytime soon. Also,
the fourth quarter is the most important part of any football game. The home team relies on the crowd's energy to help push them through, especially from the student section.
But what if we told you there's no fourth quarter crowd to give that energy? Unfortunately for CMU, that's the case.
All week long, Central Michigan students are anticipating game day.
I usually go to all the home games.
Last year I did band, so I went to every home game.
I'm not going to lie, last year I think I only missed one.
The home games. Everything that I can go to, I absolutely go.
However, their fun ends when the game is most important, by vanishing at halftime.
Low-key, they do be leaving early. They don't wait till the end.
Yep, so we got there, like, beginning of the game, and at the end of, like, halftime, the whole, like, student section was mostly, like, gone.
I think even before halftime. I think people leave after the first quarter.
I feel like it's probably because of weather. Like, the student section, they come early, they tailgate. It's either too hot or too cold, and then by halftime, everyone's ready to go home.
All right, Robert Martin here. I'm here with Jake Witt of Northern Michigan, offensive tackle. Hey, Jake, real quick, I know this has been a big day for you. Hey, how are you feeling today?
Feeling great, yeah. I tested well, had a good day. Knew I'd go well, and I have going through my preparation this spring, but yeah, I'm super happy with the results we had today.
All right, so those results were impressive for practically almost every NFL team. What teams did you talk to today after your workout?
Spoke to Vikings teams, the Bills, Packers, Rams, Giants.
And with that being said, the 236th pick in the 2023 NFL Draft, the Indianapolis Colts selects Jake Witt, tackle, Northern Michigan.
Oh, let's go.
So shout out to my guy, Dane Brugler, who gave me the heads up on Jake Witt. Jake Witt is a former tight end who moved to offensive tackle. He's 6'7", 302 pounds. He ran a 4.8940, which is, you know, that's fast now. 37-inch vertical leap. His numbers were off the charts. But what he is basically is he's just a guy who's not really ready to block anybody.
Let's keep the trend going with football in the state of Michigan. The Detroit Lions, yes, the Detroit Lions are tied for first place in the NFL. Head coach and general manager Dan Campbell and Brad Holmes in 3 years have already grasped the trust and hopes of Lions fans more than any other front office has in the Super Bowl era. And I cannot wait to see how Ford Field is rocking. But speaking of Ford, let's give a shout out and apology to Detroit Lions owner Sheila Ford. Her family has owned the Detroit Lions for over 60 years. And when she took over, she did not have an easy task to handle, especially with all of the fans not giving her a chance in the first place because of her family's struggles for success, in which they were demanding her to sell the team. And after she took over in 2020, she hired the duo of Holmes and Campbell. In 2020 and 2021, the team totaled 8 wins in those 2 years combined. She could have easily given up after the 1-6 start last season, but decided to keep fighting for the respect of Detroit fans and the success of her team. Since then, the Lions in their last 16 games are 13-3 and are currently tied for first place in all of the NFL. Hats off to Sheila Ford, everyone. She deserves it. That's a wrap for sports for today. I'm Robert Martin, sending you back to Aaron, who I will assume is going to discuss someone that I tried to stay away from in the sports media.
Thanks, Rob. I really appreciate that awesome handover, but you know you're not ready for it and you're really a Swiftie.
I'm popping a seal in Barney's. I'm signing a deal with a Sharpie. I want to sleep smoking on the and I'm burning the carpet. I grew up in vacant apartments. They're pressing up retarded. They don't even care if they die from it. They just flooding the market. Off the I nod it. I'm with the killers regardless. Don't ask me why I got a gun on me, cause you be killing the artists. I fell in love with a darling. They steady bringing up charges. Went to sleep with my ankle, mom's are going dead and I forgot to charge it. You come from the streets, the darkest. Every day sleep with a Barbie. He out of my life, he tardy. Don't shoot, we ain't arguing. How you get killed when you party? The streets and the in my audience. Look at my diamonds, they ornaments. We turn to kill in a tournament. We getting revenge, it's glorious. The two FNEs, I ordered it. I'm loving the years, I ordered it. I'm recording it. The police, they call him notorious. He did a line early. I was a band jury. Now I'm a bragging jury. I live in designer stores. I drink out of styrofoam. He taking them. I hate that he died alone. I'm leaving them snakes alone. I'm leaving them fakes alone. The homicide's getting solved. I'm leaving them Jakes alone. Cut my homie off. He a custo. If I go broke, turning cutthroat. We don't cut. Can't save us. Though. Yeah. He got two headshots, yeah. What he got rushed for.